After having given you some examples of spiritual sources that did not convince me of teaching the truth, I would like to explain to you why in the end I decided to stick with the Summit Lighthouse as my main spiritual source. Enjoy! Throughout my whole spiritual journey, as I mentioned already in my previous videos, I was simply, or maybe not so simply, looking for the truth. I read many, many books, I researched the internet, I spoke to people that were also on their spiritual journeys. I used the Summit Lighthouse as one of my spiritual sources. By the way, in this video I will be referring to TSL when speaking about the Summit Lighthouse. I read many TSL books. I used one of their pages, which is called TSL Encyclopedia, for word explanations and terms I just didn't know. It is kind of a spiritual Wikipedia. It's awesome. I'm gonna add the link below the video. So summarizing, during my whole spiritual journey, I was using the Summit Lighthouse as one of my main spiritual sources. But why in the end did I decide that I was gonna stick with them and not with other sources?
Psychism.
I had mentioned the book Unveiled Mysteries in my very first video on this channel already. There is also a second book, which is written by the same author, Guy Ballard, which is called The Magic Presence. I also read this book at the beginning of my journey. I didn't always like the teachings that are written in this book, but I felt it was the truth. In The Magic Presence, Saint Germain, one of the Ascended Masters, speaks about how
psychism
can distract you from reaching your highest potential, which you can accomplish only through and with God. So, for example, if you ever went to a fortune teller or a psychic reading, you know that some of the things they tell you might be the truth, but some of the things they predict might never happen. Even though you are aware of that fact, you still might go back over and over again, and it might be over a period of decades. Just because you would like to know something specific about your future, or you want to know what will happen in 10 years, or you want some support and some spiritual guidance on taking a decision. My point is that the psychic world, such as psychic readings and other such fascinations, are tempting. Some might become obsessed with readings and following this or that spiritual guru who professes attunement with higher spiritual realms or beings, when in fact they are communing, and dangerously so, with lower astral plane energies and beings. Some might turn their lives upside down just to comply with what a psychic revealed to them. Some might fixate on the dark-haired guy because a psychic told them that they were going to marry that guy in the future, without realizing that the real man they are supposed to get married to is standing right in front of them. Obviously, not all psychic traps are so blatant. The attractions of the psychic world can be subtle, but a common vibe that comes with it is usually a delicious fascination, and that fascination charged with human emotion can sidetrack people into thinking that they are on a true spiritual path. And this is exactly what Saint Germain meant in the book The Magic Presence. Such psychic byways lead us nowhere but away from God, and tragically also away from our life mission. The Summit Lighthouse is different. Mark and Elizabeth Prophet founded the Summit Lighthouse more than 60 years ago. Both of them were messengers of the Ascended Masters and brought forth various teachings, dictations and lectures from the Ascended Masters. TSL actually recommends you not getting involved in any
psychism
for the reasons just mentioned. They teach spiritual laws like the cosmic laws. For example, I took one class from the Summit Lighthouse on alchemy, and they would explain how Jesus was able to walk on water. It all involves magnetism and other physical laws. I'm not gonna say more, but if you're interested in the course, I'm gonna add the link below to enroll. Community. At one point of my spiritual journey, I came in contact with people who had been following the TSL teachings for decades. I asked lots of honest questions and received honest answers. They could not always answer all the questions I had, but their answers made sense. And at one point I had the opportunity to go to the TSL headquarters in Montana and spend there some time to volunteer. I was able to observe how people walked on the spiritual path and how they studied and implemented the teachings into their lives. I could really feel that this community and this place was where the Ascended Masters are tangible. You could really feel their presence there. For me, being on the spiritual path, it was so important to find a community and to connect with people that were believing in the same things that I believed in. The community really tenders the heart flame and is so important in any spiritual movement. Spiritual tools. One of the things that struck me most about TSL was that they offer a spiritual path with spiritual tools you can use, like a roadmap. If you have a specific problem, you can use those tools and solve your problems and also world conditions. I couldn't find this really with other spiritual teachers. That's why I was so struck about it. One spiritual tool, for example, is the violet flame. It is a spiritual super weapon that you can use for anything you want to change. It is a spiritual fire that basically transmutes whatever you want to transmute. So if you have a fight, for example, with a friend, or if you don't feel very well, you are depressed maybe, or you have to write a paper on a specific topic, but you have no idea how to start that paper, you can use the vile flame. It transmutes the karma that stands in between you and perfection and makes your life so much easier and better. A dear friend of mine made an excellent video about what the wild flame is. I'm gonna add the link below the video. Religion. One thing that I love about TSL is that they teach the core spiritual truths of all world religions. You can be a Hindu, a Buddhist, a Muslim, a Jew, a Christian, or belong to whatever else religion exists on this earth and still study the teachings of the Ascended Masters. Everybody is welcome, despite of their gender, race, or religion. Vast knowledge. It is amazing to see how many teachings TSL offers. If you want to learn more about the details of the heavenly hierarchies, how they are structured and what beings exist actually in heaven, if you want to learn more about with what ascended masters to connect to work in a specific problem, if you want to connect with angels or archangels, you go to TSL. They basically teach about world history, karma, reincarnation, and every single spiritual topic that exists in this world. Direct relationship with heaven. One of the game changers for my choice of the Summit Lighthouse was that they actually teach you how to personally connect to the Ascended Masters. Remember, the Ascended Masters are like our older brothers who have only our best interest in mind and want to help us in all ways possible. TSL teaches you how you can write letters to these specific beings, how you can work on specific topics with a specific Ascended Master, and how to contact them and how to nurture that relationship. You can also contact specific archangels, for example, to work with them and ask them for help. They always have your back, and it is so great to have this personal relationship to whomever you desire to connect with. I used to go to a Christian church before I found these teachings, and I did experience God. I did feel God being around and helping me. But now, having these teachings and applying them in my life, writing letters to the Ascended Masters and asking for help, that is just everything. It is really like connecting to your brother, to your family member, and asking them for help. It is an amazing feeling to know that they always have your back and that they are just there for you. Personal experience, retreats. One of the TSL teachings that I found most amazing are the teachings about the retreats. Basically, the Ascended Masters in the Summit Lighthouse teaches that our souls, while we are sleeping at night, go to retreats, which are basically schoolrooms, and we get taught so many topics from Ascended Masters, angels, archangels, and heavenly beings. While being on my spiritual journey, I had at one point a sequence of nights where I would wake up in the middle of the night with these melodies in my mind and I didn't know them. I tried to find them online, but I wasn't successful. So in the end, I would just hum the melody into my phone and record that. Just, you know, hoping that at one point I would find out what all of this was about. And about 6 months later, I watched my first church service from TSL. And all of a sudden, one of the melodies was played there. And I asked a friend, what's up with that melody? And she told me that it was the keynote of El Moria, which is called Pomp and Circumstance by Edward Elgar. A keynote is basically a musical piece that represents best the characteristics and the personality of an ascended master. At that point, I knew that 6 months before I had been in a retreat of El Moya, and I was so grateful to have that experience, and everybody can have that experience. I just find it so amazing that TSL is the only spiritual source that I could find that teaches about such retreats. Soul knowing. My last point is soul knowing, and that's just a point I can't explain in words. It's just a deep inner connection and knowing that I'm on the right path, that, you know, that there is a good reason why I have been drawn back over and over again to the Summit Lighthouse. It is just a deep inner peace and feeling of settlement that I feel with in connection with the teachings. That was all the time that I was on that spiritual journey for about, let's say, 1.5 years, more or less about 1.5 years, until I really got in touch with people from TSL and found that these teachings are my true spiritual path. And it was just a relief of having found finally what I was looking for. And I believe so many of us are looking for something out there, and we are trying this and that, and we're basically hopping from one guru to another, from one spiritual teaching to another, and we don't feel settled. We don't feel like we have found yet what we're looking for, even though we don't know what we're looking for. And my encouragement to you is just keep on keeping on. Ask God once more to help you, show you the truth, talk to people, keep on reading spiritual teachings, keep on searching for the truth, and know that God is good. God is helping you on this spiritual journey, and He will reveal the truth to you if you're honestly looking for it. Thank you so much for watching this series of videos. I hope you enjoyed it and you liked it. Please leave me a comment below the video and take care.